Good morning children, Sairam. So today we are going to see about EVS projects, okay? And I hope you have learnt all the lessons that I have taught, okay? We have completed the portions for essay 1, right? So what are the lessons we finished? We finished from lesson number 1 to lesson number 7, okay? So hereafter, in the forthcoming classes, we will be revising the lessons that we have taken already. Lesson 6, our neighborhood. Okay, so I hope all of you would have learned the lesson, right? And you would have known what is a neighborhood. So now, I want you to do an activity. Okay, so the first thing is, you're going to talk about your neighborhood. Okay, what are the things that you will talk? So the things that you want to talk is the places that surround your neighborhood. So what are the places that surround your neighborhood and who all stay near your neighborhood and who are your friends and what are the games that you play with them? Okay, so I want you to talk about your neighborhood. Okay, children. Now, the timetable, that is the timetable for the internal assessment, will be given later. Okay, you just have to prepare how to talk about your neighborhood. Okay, so the exam dates will be announced in this week. Okay, so later you can prepare about what you're going to talk, and on the day of the exam I will give you a short introduction of how you are going to talk about your neighborhood, and then on the spot you got to record and send a video which is stating about your neighborhood. Okay, so I want you to take the videos with the help of your parents and send it to me on the day of the exam. Okay, children, so what are you going to do now? First, list out what are the places that surround your neighborhood, the friends who stay near your neighborhood, and what are the games you are playing with them. Okay, then just take a video and keep it ready. So on the day of the exam you can send your videos with the help of your parents. Okay, children, the video should be not less than 2 minutes. So it can be 2 minutes or more than that. Okay, children. So next assessment is an experiment project. Okay, so you are going to demonstrate how to grow a plant and narrate the different parts of the plant. Okay, so as you have learnt in your lower classes, you know what are the parts of a plant. Right, now I'm going to tell you how to grow a plant and you are going to narrate the different parts of a plant. So this experiment is going to take about 7 days. Okay, so once you receive this video you are going to start to grow a plant. Okay, children, so with the help of your parents you are going to follow the procedure which I am going to tell you now. Okay, children, so here we start. Take a bowl with moong dal. So can you see what is moong dal? It is green in color, right? So take a bowl with moong dal and now you are going to soak them in a normal temperature water. Okay, so it's not hot water or cold water, it's a normal water you're going to soak them in. Okay, Soak them in water for 24 hours. That is, a day fully you are going to soak them in water. So the next day you rinse the water out and keep the beans in a dry place for the next 12 to 2 hours. Okay. So after that you can see small white color thread like structures coming out of the moong dal. So this shows that the moong dal has been sprouted, that is, the moong dal has started to grow. Now what are you going to do? Take a plastic bottle or a glass bottle and spread out cotton and put it in the glass tumbler. Okay, so you are going to put cotton in a glass tumbler and then you are going to add 2 spoons of water in the cotton. So you are going to add 2 spoons of water in the cotton, right? So after that the cotton becomes moist. Okay, so the water is being absorbed by the cotton, and the next step, you're going to add a few sprouted moong dal. You're going to add a few sprouted moong dal. So don't add too much, okay? So then it will become clumsy. You just add 10 to 12 moong dal, which is sprouted, right? So be sure that you should not add a lot of seeds. So again, after putting the moong dal, just take a spoon of water and sprinkle it in the glass bottle. Okay, leave it for a day. Water the plant 2 times a day. So you are going to water the plant in the morning as well as in the evening. So where are you going to keep this plant? You are going to keep it near a window. So where are you going to keep it? You are going to keep it near the window. Why? Because the plant needs sunlight, right? The plant needs sunlight. So the next day, what happens on day 1? The moong dal starts sprouting out well. So the white thread like substances starts growing. Okay? So the next day you can see a further more improvement, that is the green color that is surrounded by the moong dal gets veered off, right? It becomes light green in color and it starts growing. Okay, so the moong dal starts growing on day 2. So the third day it starts giving out to the formation of new cotyledons. Okay, so the moong dal starts growing well and small leaves come out from the moong dal. So day 5 it starts growing a little more big with leaves. Okay, so once this stage has been covered, so in the day 6 it grows into a complete plant. Now what are you going to do? From day 1 you are going to take a picture and keep it safely. So day 1, day 2, day 3, day 4, day 5 and day 6. And on the day 6 you are going to set it as a presentation, or you are going to show me how your plant has been grown from the moong dal into a plant, and you are going to explain me what are the things that a plant requires to grow. So what are the things that are required for the plants to grow? Soil, water and sunlight, right? So next you're going to show me where is the root and where is the stem. So where is the root here? So the root is here, right? So the root is here down, and this is the stem, and you can see leaves here. So now in that video which you're going to take, you're going to show me where is the root and where is the stem and where is the leaves and how your plant has grown. Okay children, so once you start watching this video, take a bowl, take 1 spoon of moong dal and soak it in water and start growing your plant. Okay, so only then it will be ready by the day of the internal exam. Okay children, so will you do that? Yes. So you all are going to plant and grow seeds, isn't it? Yes. So next is the project which I told you, I'll be teaching you how to make a Christmas tree, isn't it? So I told you, no, how I will teach you to make a Christmas tree. So are you ready to watch how to make a Christmas tree? Yes. So now take a green color paper, so it should be of A4 size, and you fold it into a triangle. So this is how you are going to fold it. So have you folded? Yes. So once you have folded that, now you are going to cut off the rectangle that is present down. So just press it hardly and flap it out. Now using your scissors, you are going to cut the remaining rectangle that is present. Okay, so children, while using scissors, take the help of your parents. Okay, now flip it open. Now fold it into two. So once you have folded this into two, just give a slight press so that you will be able to see the markings of where you have pressed the paper hard. So again flip it open, divide that into four equal parts. Okay, so now you're going to divide it into four, giving a slight press. So have you pressed it? Okay, now flip it open and see, can you see that four divisions are here? Now diagonally you're going to flap it. So flap it diagonally so it becomes into a triangle. So once the triangle is ready, just press it hard so that you will be able to see the impressions. Right children? So next, flip it open. Now can you see the marks that are present? Yes. So now fold it into four squares. Okay, and gently give a press over the fingers, over the sheet of paper. Now again give a press and move it. So likewise you can do it and flip it open so that it becomes into a cone shaped figure. So by doing this you will get more partitions for the Christmas tree. So now you're going to open another triangle, flip it open, make it into two equal halves and just give a gentle press so that you will have more divisions for the Christmas tree. Okay, so can you see this? So in this way you do it for all the four sides and you will be getting 12 different sides. Okay, so again you do this, press it firmly, make sure that the edges are perfect and you get more partitions. Okay, so there will be 12 sides and 8 sheets like this. Okay, so flip it open, give a gentle press give a gentle press and then again make sure that all the sides are equal and not clumsy. So the remaining things with the help of the scissors you can cut it down. Okay, now partly a Christmas tree is ready, but still we have to make some incisions to make it look beautiful. Okay, so just give a cut, not fully, okay, just closer to the midpoint. Okay, so you are going to give 4 slits. Don't cut it fully, just give a cut which comes closer to the middle part but not fully. Okay, so by making this cut you going to get a sequence of Christmas tree. Okay, so now carefully remove that. Be careful, so when you're going to do this heart it tends to tear. Okay, now facing downwards you're going to make a small impression. Okay, so it should be an exact triangle, so do it carefully with the help of your parents. So facing down you should do for all the sides on the Christmas tree. So do it like this on all the sides. You're going to face it downwards, don't do it up, it will look funny. So do it downwards, just give a gentle press again. Go down and press. Go down and give a press. So like that you're going to do for all the sides. Go down and press. Down and press. So far we have completed 3. So next we are going to do the 4th one. Down and press. Down and press. So the 5th one, down and press, down and press, down and press. Now the 6th one, next we come on to the 7th one, and finally it is the 8th one we are going to do. Okay, so that's all, we have completed our Christmas tree. Now flap it open. So can you see this? Wow, it looks beautiful, isn't it? So like this you can do different types of Christmas trees in different colors and make it attractive using felt pens. Okay, so can you see this? So like this you can do it. Okay, so have you seen how to make a Christmas tree? So that's all. So like that you can make a Christmas tree, and this Christmas tree project is not for internal exams, it is just a project for lesson number 7 festivals. Okay, so thank you children, you're going to do all these projects to get good marks, isn't it? Yes, thank you children.